Today, we will try to explain our meditation retreats important factors. I want to ask you what is the most important thing for you to do in this Buddha's dispensation. How do you think? According to Buddha's teaching, there is one short stanza I want to recite. Jaheya sabha sanyoga kriya sarana jana Chiriya dhijja si so wa pachaya ichudam padam. What is the meaning? Number one, Zaheya Sabha Sanyoga. You must relinquish all factors, all bonds. Sanyojana. This is the most important thing. Why? These sanyojanas in time of death appear in your mind. These patterns, such as attachment to sensual pleasures, worries, remorse, angers, etc. Near death moment, if they appear in your mind, that unwholesome dhammas will produce to be reborn in one of four whole states. So, to relinquish these fetters is most important thing, one of the most important things. Number two is kriya sarana dana. You must do your own refuge. Others can do nothing for you. Buddhas are showing the path leading to the Nibbana only. They do not, they are not sevas. You must do your own refuge by yourself. This is second important thing. Number three. Chiriya dhidda si so va padhyaya ichudam padam. There is one person whose topic is money. What is the most important thing for him to do at that time? The most important thing for him to do at that time is to extinguish this fire burning to his tablet. But Buddha says, please put aside to extinguish this burning fire. Please try to relinquish Sakaya deity identity view. This Sakaya deity identity view is main fundamental factor to be reborn in woeful states after death. So because of this reason, please put aside the burning fire in your head, on your head. Please extinguish the identity view Sakaya deity, wishing for realization of Nibbana. For realization of Nibbana, how you should try? You must practice Noble Eightfold Path. What are Noble Eightfold Paths? Number one, Samadhi, right view. Number two, Samasankappa, right intention. Number three, Samavacca, right speech. Number four, Samagamanda, right action. Number five, Samajiva, right livelihood. Number six, Samavayama, right effort. Number seven, Samasati, right mindfulness. Number eight, Samasamadhi, right concentration. Altogether, there are eight factors. These eight factors are called Noble Eightfold Path. This is the only way leading to the realization of Nirvana. Again, if we summarize this noble Eightfold Path, there are three trainings. The training of morality, the training of concentration, and the training of wisdom. What is the training of morality? Samavacca, right speech. Samagamanda, right action. And Samajiva, right livelihood. These three factors are the training of morality. Samavayama, right effort. Samasati, right mindfulness. Samasamadhi, right concentration. These three trainings are the training of concentration. Samadhi, right view. Samasankappa, right intention. These two factors are the training of wisdom. While practicing Noble Eightfold Path, there are some meditators who had already practiced Sila and Samadhi. For example, five group bhikkhus, Pinchavagya bhikkhus, they had already practiced Sila, purification of Paju. They have enough concentration. Because of this reason, Buddha teaches them directly the training of wisdom, Samadhi, right view, and Samasankappa, right intention. What is Samadhi? In Mahasri Brahma Sutta, Buddha explains, Kadamancha bhikkhave samadhi. Yandokhe jnana, dukkha samudaye jnana, dukkha nirodhe jnana, dukkha nirodha gamini abhidhipadaya jnana, ayam ucchati bhikkhave samadhi. In this way, Buddha taught. What is the meaning? The right understanding of noble truth of suffering, dukkha, seja, by direct knowledge. The right understanding of the noble truth of the origin of suffering, samudaya, seja, by direct knowledge. The right understanding of the noble truth of the cessation of suffering, nirodha, seja, by direct knowledge. The noble truth of the path leading to the cessation of suffering, dukkha nirodha gamini buddhibuddha ariya seja, by direct knowledge. These four types of direct knowledge is called samadhi, right view, right understanding. Sammasangkappa right intention is associated with samadhi. Sammasangkappa applies the mind to the Four Noble Truth object. At that time, samadhi understands the Four Noble Truths only. Again, there are some meditators whose bhagya is purified. At that time, Buddha does not teach them for the purification of bhagya. Buddha directly teach samadhi concentration. For example, in Sijja Sanyoga, there is one sutta which says that samadhi bhikkhave bhaveta samahito bhikkhave bhikkhu yatha buddham bhajanati kincha yatha buddham bhajanati idam dukkhanti yatha buddham bhajanati ayam dukkha samudayati yatha buddham bhajanati ayam dukkha nirodhati yatha buddham bhajanati ayam dukkha nirodha gamiti paripadati yatha buddham bhajanati. Because quality by concentration. A bhikkhu who has concentrated mind understands the dhammas as they really are. What does he understand as it really is? He understands as it really is. This is the noble truth of suffering, dukkha, sijja. He understands as it really is. This is the noble truth of the origin of suffering, samudaya, sijja. He understands as it really is. This is the noble truth of the cessation of suffering, nirodha, sijja. He understands as it really is. This is the noble truth of the path leading to the cessation of suffering. In this way, Buddha teach. Because of this reason, for clear understanding of the Four Noble Truths, you must cultivate concentration. Again, there are also some meditators who has no purification of bhajya. For those who have no purification of bhajya, Buddha teach Noble Eightfold Path systematically. Number one, the training of morality, sila. Number two, the training of concentration, samadhi. And then number three, the training of wisdom, pinya. So these sila, samadhi, and pinya, Buddha teach systematically, stage by stage. So please try to see this chart. We are explaining Noble Eightfold Path stage by stage. On the top there is Nibbana. For realization of Nibbana, you must do sila, samadhi, pinya. The training of morality, the training of concentration, and the training of wisdom. Among these three trainings, number one, the training of morality is at least 5 precepts or 8 precepts or 9 precepts are necessary for lay devotees. For bhikkhus and bhikkhunis, there must be 4. Number one, Patimokkha Samvara Sila. This is Vinaya rules, observing Vinaya rules. Number two, Indriya Samvara Sila. Controlling, observing, controlling faculties. Number three, Ajiva Parisuddhi Sila. The purification of livelihood. Number four, Pichya Sannisiddha Sila. While using 4 requisites, at least one time or two times or three times, etc., you must reflecting knowledge. After the purification of Bhajju, if you had already purified your Bhajju, then you can continue the training of concentration samadhi. There are 40 samatha meditation subjects. You can choose anyone, but for beginners, usually we teach anapana, mindfulness of breathing, or four elements meditation. Some meditators, if they practice four elements meditation, their concentration becomes very deep. They can attain quickly up to excess concentration stage. But for some meditators, they must practice anapana. Anapana meditation can produce to attain up to fourth jhana stage. So, a meditator should try to choose one of these two meditation subjects. If you are successful up to four elements meditation, up to excess concentration stage, or mindfulness of breathing, anapana meditation, up to fourth jhana stage, at the time, your concentrated mind will produce strong and powerful, brilliant, transparent lights. This light is called the light of wisdom. With the assistance of the light of wisdom, if you discern 32 paths, both internally and externally, then you can clearly see these 32 parts of your body. If you can discern 32 parts, both internally and externally, then there are three ways you can continue. If you practice repulsiveness meditation, particular manasikara, repulsiveness and intention. Repulsiveness, attention. Then you can attain first jhana. If you practice kala kasinas, you can attain up to fourth jhana stage. Then you can continue other kasinas, and again, you can continue up to four formless jhanas, four immaterial jhanas. Altogether, you can practice eight attainments. Some meditators, they don't like to practice kasinas. They will directly go to vipassana. It is also possible they can directly go to vipassana. If they want to practice vipassana directly from anapana or four elements meditation or mindfulness of breathing meditation, anapana meditation, it is also possible to practice rupa gamadhana material meditation subject. But it is advisable to practice kasinas, because kasina jhanas produce very deep and profound concentration. If a meditator has very deep and profound concentration, when his concentration is very powerful, at the time, strong, powerful lights appear. This is called the light of wisdom.